Hello, everybody. This is Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play Spyro 2 Ripto's Rage for the PlayStation 1. In our last episode, we explored the home world for the second set of worlds, Autumn Plains, and learned how to climb. And also, we returned to Summer Forest to get our final orb for that area, so the Summer Forest homeworld is now complete, but we are not completely done in Summer Forest. And so we have returned to Sunny Beach to do the final two orb challenges, which can be found at the top of that ladder over there. So let's get the story.
Hello, young one. There's a chef up at the top of this ladder who wants to make soup out of our turtles. Maybe you could climb up there and stop him.
I think I can. For a price. Alright, so it's finally time to finish this level.
Your turtle friends happen to make a very good soup. If I can catch them. You can try to save them if you like, but I'm feeling awfully hungry.
I'm sorry to hear that, but I'm afraid, lunch will not be served. So what you gotta do is, the chef will ring his, triangle thing. Triangle, that's what it's actually called. And, the turtles will try to walk towards the, pot. Yeah, these turtles aren't too smart. And what you gotta do is, you gotta headbutt them and charge them.
So, you saved a few turtles. There are more where those came from. Here, take this orb and go away.
Oh, I'm afraid I can't go away yet. Okay, so it's time for the second phase of the challenge. There are going to be more turtles coming, and there's more at a time, so you have to be quick. Now, as I was trying to explain earlier, you got to knock the turtles away from the pot into that pool of water. And once all the turtles have been saved, the challenge will be over. Yeah, how do you like that? Alright, now things are going to get really hectic. Nope. I don't think so. Where you going, huh? Get in there. Oh, no you don't. Ah! No! Get away from there! Okay, let's try that again. I missed the turtle completely. I don't know how that happened. So yep, there's our first failure of the LP. First time we've actually failed an orb challenge. Not proud of that. No! Oh! No! Jeez, it's like playing pool. Get away. There's not supposed to be this many at a given time. Get away from there. No. I don't think so. No, I'm not blowing it this time, buddy. Get in there. Oh, there's come on. No! Why? Darn it. Jeez. What should take 5 minutes is gonna take 10. I have forgotten just how many turtles there are. I thought I had it one right there, and then like three of them come out of nowhere. And I don't have a chance to get all of them, you know? Get away. No you don't. Oh my god! No! No! You are forbidden to go near the pot. You are entering a restricted area. No! Give me a break! Three fails in a row, this can't be happening! Okay, first... You have got to be kidding me. How does he not go in there? This is not how I planned this part to go. I didn't anticipate that I would be here for any longer than maybe 5 minutes. This was supposed to be a nice short episode of me finishing off the last orb challenges for Summer Forest, and instead, it's turning into an epic fight for survival. No, go that way. Oh, yeah. Oh, come on. Get in the water. I want you to go into the water. That is where you belong. Yeah, now we're talking. I can't get too cocky. Bam! Come on. Get in there. I forgot just how many turtles there are. I really don't know the exact number. But you gotta work quick or else they'll overwhelm you and you won't be able to save all of them. I think there's, what, 15?
Rats! You save every turtle on the beach. Here, take this. I was gonna use it to buy potatoes, but now I don't need it.
God! Okay, that didn't take as long as I was thinking it would take. I mean, I usually don't fail that challenge that many times in a row. Jeez. Alright, so... Oh, wait a second. How could I forget? Okay, now Sunny Beach is done. Now we have all the gems. I forgot. There are gems in that pool of water, so... Sunny Beach is officially done! And by extension, everything in Summer Forest is now complete. In fact, we'll pause here and take a look at the guidebook. Now, the guidebook is basically a little feature that helps you watch your progress. I really meant to explain this way back in like the first video, but the guidebook basically gives you data on everything you've done so far in the game, like how many gems you've gathered, how many talismans you have, how many orbs you have, and what percentage of any given level you've completed. So as you can see here, we have done everything 100% in Summer Forest, the home world is done, all the levels are done, the speedway's done, and the boss level is done. Now if you select an individual level, you will be taken to a special section dedicated to that level. So each level page has the amount of treasure, the orbs, and the talisman. So for example, Glimmer, we have the talisman and all three orbs and all 400 gems, and like so for every other level. And then we have Autumn Plains. The only thing we've done so far is the home world, which does not contain a talisman. But we'll get to those levels in a later episode. So yeah, that's the guidebook feature, and everything in Summer Forest is officially done. We no longer have to come back for anything, so... Let us depart! There's no need for us to stick around here if there's nothing to do. So, step into the teleporter, and we will be taken to Autumn Plains. I think I took the wrong teleporter, though. Because we're going to be dumped way inside the castle and stuff. Yeah, this is... We've been taken to where the boss door is, which is not going to open for a while. Now, since I'm in a reasonably good mood, despite the fact that I failed multiple times on that turtle challenge, we're going to have some fun here in Autumn Plains. I think I'm going to squeeze in another stage. Just so this video isn't quite so short. What we're gonna do is, we're gonna go all the way to the first area, and I know in an earlier episode I think I said we were going to do Crystal Glacier first, but I've changed my mind. We're gonna do the Speedway levels first and get them out of the way immediately. And we will start off with Metro Speedway. So let's go! Alright, here we go. Same setup as Ocean Speedway. Four targets, eight of each that we have to destroy. And if we destroy all the targets within the time limit, we will get a whole bunch of treasure. So we're going to start off by taking out all these pigeons, which will actually help us unlock other paths through the level so we can take out more targets. And we're also going to be taking out bungee jumpers along the way. Sorry guys, but your little day of thrill-seeking is about to meet a tragic end. Hope you guys know how to swim. Yeah. I am definitely not going to break any records with this run. I don't think this is the most efficient way to go through this stage, but whatever. Oh crap, time is sneaking up on me. Destroy these gates by supercharging. Whenever you do a charge along the ground in a flight level, you automatically do a supercharge, no matter what. It's always a supercharge. I think I messed up the order. But if we work fast, we might just be able to get all the targets. Come on. Where's the last one? Woo, that was close. Yeah, getting those bungee jumpers took a little longer than it should have, and I really cut it close there. I almost didn't make it, so yeah, not gonna break any records. Could have been quicker, but whatever. We got the challenge done, so now it's time to do the orb challenge. And we can find the orb challenge by going into here. No! Apparently Spyro can't really do a hover. Now he does the hover.
We've been having a crime problem here at Metro Speedway, but I think you might be able to help. A band of cat burglars have been raiding my re-election funds by scaling the walls of the buildings. Would you be willing to help get rid of them?
Happy to help. Let's go take care of some burglars.
Great. The hunter has been able to knock the scoundrels off of the buildings. But we need you to catch the loot before it lands in the canal and is lost. The hunter is waiting for you outside. Good luck.
The hunter? Huh. Who could that be? Catch the loot before it lands. 5-star difficulty. It's nothing we can't handle. Okay, so we gotta follow Hunter, who's flying around. He's gonna blast the burglars off the building. Well, he's gonna hit them, and they're gonna lose their loot. And we have to grab the bags of loot before they hit the water. If even one of these bags of loot hits the water, we have to restart the entire challenge. And some of them come pretty close. You have to be quick on some of these, especially towards the end. But we're halfway there. No, I'm not missing it. Hunter, wait for me! Alright, one more to go. Bring it on.
Well done. You really taught those crooks a lesson.
That wasn't so hard. Then again, I do have a fair amount of practice when it comes to that challenge, so of course it would be easy. So there it is, secret challenge orb awarded. We are done here. But I think I'm going to cut it off here. I don't think I'm really going to be able to fit in the second speedway without the episode becoming a little too long. So, on that note, we are going to cut off here. So, yep, that's it for this episode of Let's Play Spyro 2 Ripto's Rage for the PlayStation 1. We have finished Sunny Beach in Summer Forest, and by extension, Summer Forest is completely done. That set of worlds, we don't have to go back to it. And we have also finished the first Speedway of Autumn Plains, Metro Speedway. So, yeah, we actually accomplished quite a bit in this part. So, this is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. If you liked what you saw here, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see all of you in the next episode.